Hello everyone, welcome to the Chronicles of Riddick, Escape from Butcher Bay. Most games that are based on movies are pretty freaking terrible, but this is one giant exception. It's actually really good. It came out in 2004. I originally played it a long time ago, when I was much younger. I don't remember that much about it other than it's really damn good. So let's start getting into a new game here. One thing I do want to mention though is that you can get a physical copy of it. I don't think it's on Steam or anything like that. However, I would recommend getting it from GOG.com, which is where I got my copy from. And the reason for that is because the original version of this game comes with a particularly terrible form of DRM that pretty much rivals Star Force for being freaking terrible. And of course, GOG.com being a place that doesn't sell games with any DRM whatsoever, they always rip it out if it ever had it in the first place. That means their copy of it does not come with that DRM. So, I would highly recommend that. Okay, let's get going. Escape from Butcher Bay. Let's go with normal difficulty.
We're moving again. They just transmitted a safe route through the minefield.
That minefield's offering better odds than you're gonna get taking me to Butcher Bay. You think Hoxie's memory is that short?
He gets one look at you, Riddick, and all is forgiven. And I bank your bounty plus 50.
Plus 50? Now come on, Johns. Greed is an ugly thing.
You're in no position to negotiate, Riddick.
Forgot you don't like this part. Statistically, landings are the most dangerous.
You got nothing left to live for, Riddick. I do. Now shut up, would you?
You're already counting it, aren't you?
I said shut up.
Your funeral.
Hey, hold it. You go where I say, when I say. Hey, don't fucking move.
Today, Johns, you get fucked.
You don't move until I say so. Hey, hold it. You go where I say, when I say.
I just wanted to look around.
The dialogue at the very beginning is a little bit strange to me.
Today is the day you get fucked.
So yeah, again, this game came out in 2004, but it still holds up really well today. It looks damn good. Okay, well, I can do a little something here.
Riddick, Jones has his back at you. Attack him.
Indeed.
Whoa, come! I rule!
DNA protection. New meat learns the hard way.
We should get moving.
You're in violation.
Now, something I want to mention is that this might seem a bit strange to begin with. I played through the first, 15-20 minutes of this game again just to make sure everything's working good. And when I first got to this part, I thought, what the hell's going on? Wait a minute, this guy who knows I'm a high security risk? I'm one of the biggest badasses in the world? So much so that just, cashing in the bounty on me can earn him a shit ton, and yet he doesn't put me in cuffs or anything like that and turns his back to me? I thought, what? That doesn't make any damn sense. And then I realized how incredibly clever this game actually is. You'll see later on, but trust me, there's a reason for this. And it'll all make sense very soon. It's actually really clever. Pack of smokes. You've already found this package. Oh, that's from when I played before. I guess even if you restart the game, the previous things you find like that, the collectibles, as those are, continue on. For some reason, finding packets of cigarettes are collectibles in this game. Not really sure why, but okay. Hello.
I've got a runner here, Code Red!
Come on.
Ah, no!
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's got a really nice melee system in this game. Take that security card, thank you. And just as the gun up there fried that guy, it would fry me too.
Unauthorized.
So let's not do that. Although I guess because I'm 100% more awesome than the other guy, I take 100% less damage. I mean, well, 95% less damage. Hurts me just a little bit.
Unauthorized. Access granted.
I still can't believe how good this game looks for being 10 years old. So this is basically the tutorial section, obviously.
Look around the corner. See what this piece of meat's up to.
Be very, very quiet.
I gotta drop him. I should hide the body. Someone might notice.
Gotta say, I absolutely love Vin Diesel's gravelly voice.
Darkness. I can hide the bodies here.
There's something about it I just really like. So yeah, I mean, it's got a really good melee system. It's got some solid FPS combat, as you'll see later on. It's got some pretty good stealth elements. It's really cool. Whoops. I could listen to that gravelly voice all day. Ah, yes, I remember finding something special down here. Oh, another cool thing about this game, by the way, is that you actually can see the rest of your body. You actually have a body. Unlike a lot of games where you're just kind of a floating camera. So, pretty cool. It's also fun to punch the wall. That's gotta hurt. But he's Vin Diesel. He doesn't give a shit. Money! And a pack of smokes that I've already gotten. I actually have no idea what I'm gonna do with the money. Let's head up to that vent. Hi there. Recharge this thing. There we go. Oh. It's a shame I'm not hurt. I'd love to show you the animation for this thing. It looks, rather painful. Basically, gigantic spikes shoot out of it and kind of push into your neck. It's really disturbing, frankly.
Just take the gun.
I love his voice. If only I had a voice just as gravelly. But I don't. Okay, the help for this one is that you can disarm a guard if you attack them when they just try to hit you. This requires careful timing. It does, it's pretty difficult. You gotta be patient. It's like a dodge in Dark Souls. You gotta wait until just the right moment.
And shit! Gun!
Oh, there we go. Boom! Already grab that. Oh, now I can show you the med station thing. Or maybe not, never mind. This gun does not shock me when I try to pick it up for some reason. I have no idea why. Hold Z down and move around to select a weapon. What the hell? Ugh. That's some console thing. I think I'd rather just use the mouse wheel, thank you. Damn it, I wanted to hurt myself. Really wanted to show you the med station. I don't know what the hell they have in this trash thing, but it's really nasty. Fun fact, one of the developers behind the game, I think it's Tygon Studios, was actually founded by Vin Diesel himself. Yay, jittery elevator.
Guards with shotguns. I have to kill him to take it.
Wait, where did my shotgun go? Okay, that's weird. I actually can't select it with the scroll wheel for some reason. I have to press Z? Huh. I suppose I could shoot him, but why don't I instead just use my fists?
That smell. Sewers. Could be a way out.
I have no idea why I'm dragging him. I kind of wanted to push him off the ledge, but that didn't work. Nor did that work. Anyway.
Locked. Not a problem. I'll blast it off.
I love how confident he is. I feel like I can do anything. Like nothing's a problem. Everything's solvable. Thanks to his gravelly voice.
The dark. My favorite.
Well, nothing here. Keep looking.
Nothing here, huh?
Okay. Who the fuck did this? You mother.
Rise and shine, jackass. Come on, don't act like you're asleep. It's time for you to earn me some money.
You might want to be careful with that, Johns. You could hurt somebody. Butcher Bay. You know, you always take me to the nicest places, Johns.
The food's good as well. Can't say I'm gonna miss you, Riddick.
Then don't. Up, Johns. Looks like that memory's still intact. He don't look all that happy to see you.
My Hoxie's a businessman. Now play nice and we can get this over with quickly.
It's already over, Johns.
Secure your weapon, Johns.
Good to see you too, Warden.
So the famous Mr. Riddick.
The Hawks.
Finally come to stay, eh? Well, as of this moment, Butcher Bay owns your ass.
I own your ass.
He's all yours once I sign him over, Hoxie.
You're not going to be a problem, are you, Riddick? Because my boys and I like solving problems.
John said you were ugly up close. For the first time, I gotta agree with him.
Nice try.
I do what I can.
Already trying to get under my skin, eh, Riddick?
Be easier if I had something sharp.
Bounty plus 50 on Riddick. Right, Hoxie?
I think Riddick about covers what you owe me, Johns.
There's plenty other slams I can take Riddick to if you can't afford them.
All right, all right. Perhaps we can come to a number, but don't push it, Johns. Extra, no. Riddick stays at Butcher Bay. Period. Full stop. Let's get him processed.
Yes, sir.
Johns, better luck next time.
Prisoner walking! All right, pay attention, punk. You are now Butcher Bay Prisoner 542-1135-2. Remember your number. Remember the rules. My rules. Now listen, there's no outside at Butcher's. Just a whole planet of desert. So check those desires right now, because you will not get out. No one has, no one ever will. Okay, close the gate. No physical contact with other inmates whatsoever. No contraband of any kind. Don't ask what's contraband. I define it day by day. So spare yourself and carry nothing but lint in those pockets.
It's time for us to delouse your filthy ass. Don't breathe.
Cleansing routines, an indignity of slam life, lets the mercs think they're in charge. That's their weakness, the foolish belief that they're in control. It'll be their downfall.
So, as if this wasn't a good game already, you can flush the toilets. Game of the year. All years. So yeah, the beginning section, which was very strange narratively, for me to be able to escape so easily, was actually just either a dream or a fantasy. And it also serves as a perfect way to just have a tutorial and introduce you to all these concepts that wouldn't make sense to happen narratively. Obviously, if you're being put in jail, it doesn't make sense for you to have a weapon so early on, and all that stuff, but it introduces all those concepts. So it's actually incredibly clever. toilet doesn't appear to have any water. Huh. Worrying. Yeah, it's a damn good looking game, 10 years old. I mean, man. Alright.
Hey, come talk to me for a second, will you? You're Riddick, right? There's a guy named Madsen talking like he knows you. He's in the courtyard, just by the pit. I don't know what Madsen wants with you, but I'd go check it out if I were you.
Nasty trash once again. Oh god, I remember listening to what's in front of this door. Or, I mean, listening in front of this door to what's happening inside of it. It's really fucking disturbing.
It's the Cozart brothers, aka the Torture Twins. Locked down yesterday, managed to get hold of some poor side, obviously.
Also, holy shit, what is up with your eyes? My god. So yeah, they're torturing somebody in there. Pleasant. What happened to you?
You see this face? All thanks to Molina. Waste him when they open his cell. And I'll make it worth your while.
Right, I don't actually know Molina, so I'm gonna say no.
Not gonna happen.
That was a strange camera angle. I've noticed this game has some very strange camera angles during the conversations.
You won't ever walk into the infirmary, punk. Maybe we'll drag you in when Rust is finished with you. Now piss off.
Who the hell is this Rust I keep hearing about?
My advice. Do like all the other fish. Line up behind Rust.
Always being watched.
Single most stupid idea I ever heard.
Why? It'll work.
No fucking way, no! It will never work. And you know why?
No, tell me.
Well, there are two things. First, you are a fucking moron. That's number one. Number two is one simple fact, a fact you know. Things like gravity and hand jobs. Number two is as simple as you are.
I'm not simple.
Then your idea must be brilliant. But it's shit! And why? Wanna hear reason number two? Those rifles the guards carry, they are DNA encoded.
What do you mean?
Well, you know what DNA is, right? Those rifles track your DNA. They won't fire a single damn cap unless you're in the central database, which you aren't.
But what if I could get into that database?
That is a fact. You hear me? Fact. You cannot use the guns, period.
But what if I could get into that database?
What do you mean, get into that database? You can't!
I've seen a map over this place. The database computer's not that far off.
Who the hell told you this?
I forget. I'm simple. Remember?
Oh, great! You're lying, Girish! You're a fucking liar!
Don't want to talk about it? Okay.
New guy. If I were you, I'd get a shiv.
You know, he sounded very much like Arnold Schwarzenegger for a second there.
Wanna live? Get a shiv.
What are you looking at? Go play with the twins or something. Oh, hey, wait. You're that new guy, right? You wanna do me a favor?
What have you got in mind?
I don't do favors. But tell me anyway.
Listen. The moment Molina's lockdown expires, I wanna see him dead. Dead and killed. That's what I want you to do. You come back to me when he's dead.
Alright, so at least two people want Molina dead. Sounds like a bit of an asshole, but I think I wanna talk to him myself, maybe.
Well, there's always the pit. But to tell you the truth, Jack, you're here because you didn't pay your damn lawman in the first place.
You got that right. And it applies to all of us. Hey, what's this fuss about Crazy Flyer?
He's going on and on about busting out and claims he's actually found a way. That crazy bastard will probably just kill himself and get us all a month of runner lockdown.
Well, somebody should stop him. For our own good. Unless Crazy Flyer is not so crazy.
What, you think he's really got something going? A real plan?
It's worth sniffing around for details.
Yeah, well, that's where the devil lives. In the details.
I believe this voice actor here.
You should see Haley. He can help you out.
He really sounds like that... I can't remember his character's name, but that complete asshole from the Walking Dead TV show. I don't remember his name. You know, the one that got, like, his hand cut off or something? Early on, and reappeared later?
I told you, Riddick. Go see Haley. He can help you out.
You're gonna get in trouble with the Aquila Majors, I'll tell you. Look, go on, talk to Haley. He's the wise man. Well, actually, he used to be a guard, but he turned over to the good side.
How you doing there, buddy?
Bring it like an angel.
Okay. I'm pretty sure he just gets up and wanders off. I don't think he actually says anything worth a damn.
Bring it like an angel.
Yeah.
The pit. Looks like a way out.
Hey, Matson. What's up?
What can I say?
I know what you mean. No, see ya.
Yeah, later.
Alright, I'm apparently supposed to talk to both of you, Haley and Matson. Let's go with you first.
Talking about me? Never wise.
Oh yeah, no, I mean, I heard you were coming. You're going to want a shiv and I can get you one. Check my bunk and you'll find one. It's yours.
Excellent. I believe it's, A40 is where it is? Yeah, A40 is a cell. Get the shiv.
Go back into Block A and take a right. My cell's in the last one on the right. The shiv is in my bunk.
I knew you'd come eventually. Listen, Riddick. Rust pulls all the strings in this block. Personally, I don't much care for that. He's a thorn in my side. You want my help, Riddick? Remove the thorn. Get Rust.
Okay, everybody wants me to kill everybody. How about I just murder every single person in here and then all my problems will be solved?
New fish in the tank. How do you like it here, Riddick?
I don't.
Name's Red. Tell me, Riddick, how did it feel when you killed your first one?
That's between me and him.
In Butcher Bay, some men kill for nothing but pleasure.
You know, there are worse reasons.
Some, like Rust, I'd be happy to see gone.
So it's even got a bit of an RPG system. As you can see, it actually has, well, missions, basically quests. Kill Melina. Kill Rust.
How you doing, Red?
Just fine. What's up?
Nothing really. Any news?
Same old shit, you know.
Okay. See ya.
Bring it like
I don't know if he's just drunk or delirious or what.
Shit. I ain't gonna make it. I need to score some shit, man.
Hey, easy, man. Easy. You know, Russ won't let anything through. You just have to tie yourself in, sit back, and just wait for the big, nice tide to just come and get you through.
Easy for you to say. But all I gotta say is it better be a fucking monster tide when it does come in.
yeah. I'm sure it's gonna be good.
The way his facial expression just went from a huge smile to just dead. Really awkward. Alright, A40. There we go. Let's get ourselves a little shiv. Under the bed, right?
Riddick, Russ bid you welcome to Butcher Bay.
Fuck you. Oh god. Fuck you! Yeah. Welcome to Butcher Bay.
Set up the ambush. Obviously works for Rust. But he'll turn when I tighten the screws.
Alright, I don't feel too bad about killing this Rust asshole now. Well, obviously there won't be a shiv here. I have no idea why I just did that. What does it say? I beat prison meat. Okay. I wonder what would happen if I just dragged these bodies out in front of the guards. They'd probably lock me away. Let's go have a chat with this asshole.
You know there's no way out of this slam.
Hey! I didn't find a shiv.
Hey, let me explain. It was Rust. He forced me to. But I knew those goons were no match for you. I'll get you a shiv to set things right. You have my word.
Cross me again, and I'll have your life. Talk.
I don't know anything. Not compared to Haley. He's been here for ages. Used to be a guard. Let me set things straight. I'll bring that shiv to your cell. Just go there and wait.
It's not like his word is worth very much at this point, but alright. Hope I don't find more surprises at my cell. What is my cell, anyway? Is it this one? Yes.
I got the shiv you wanted, Riddick.
What the F you think you're doing, Mattson? You dealing without my approval?
You're in my cell.
You need a blade. You come to me.
I said, you're in my cell.
What? Wrong. All these cells belong to the Achilleans, including this one. Now you ain't paid me for that shank, so it ain't yours.
Come take it.
You got a hearing problem. I said everything I see belongs to me.
See this? It belongs to me.
Release him, Riddick. Rust is mine, and I will personally bring hell down on you if you don't let him go. I thought you were the big dog, Russ. Maybe he's more your size.
Yes, sir, Mr. Abbott.
You are messing with the natural order of things, Riddick. And when that happens, well, as you can see, people can get hurt.
Or worse.
Indeed. And we don't want that.
Speak for yourself.
We have a problem. Disturbance at cell block 9. Send in the squad. Send in the squad.
This better not be one of your Keelan boys. Abbott here. Responding to cell block 9.
Rust and the Keelan mages pretended to run the show, but everyone knew they fed on crumbs. Crumbs that fell from Abbott's table.
Sorry about that, Madison. Or Mattson.
Rust is waiting for you in the Achilles block. He won't stop till you're dead, so you better find a weapon. Woman can help.
All right.
Russ will kill you unless you join him.
Well, I'm not joining him. And I'm also not gonna die. Oh god, he's listening to the torture. Alright, I need a shiv. Woman. Who is Woman? Ah.
You kill Molina, then you come back. Okay?
I guess I do need to actually kill Molina. Oh. You're Molina. Hi.
I don't know what you're after, okay? But Haley knows how things work here. Check the courtyard.
Let's explore around a bit more before I do something drastic.
Shit. I ain't gonna make it.
I know what you mean. Get Rust, and I'll help you.
You got a problem, huh? Go fuck yourself.
His name's Booger.
I'm watching you, shithead.
Ooh, I'm scared. Oh, right, this is the cell block I shouldn't go into, right? Check my missions, huh? Yep, Russ is waiting for you in Aquila territory. You should probably get a weapon before you face him. It says probably, it doesn't say you need. But... okay. Need to get Rust before Haley will talk to me. Probably shouldn't get Rust until I've done the Woman thing, so that means I guess I need to kill Molina. I don't actually have a weapon, so I guess I'm just gonna punch him to death. Yes, yes, I know, you've had that conversation like 10 times already. Okay. Anybody watching?
You still doing that shit? You should get a Stair Cruncher Double Plus. That'll rip.
Piss off, Jimbo.
Okay, okay. I'm gone.
What? Is that some exercise equipment or something? Can I. Do I just start. Alright, I'm. Alright. Okay then, that should do it. And of course the customary end of battle, flushing of the toilet. It really doesn't seem like I killed him though, it just seems like I knocked him out, but let's see if that doesn't.
Shall I tell you what that bastard Molina did to me? It's so much I don't even know where to start. But this is for you. Thanks.
Bag of smokes. Warning, smoking may seriously affect your death. Each separate pack of cigarettes has a different little warning on it. Okay, what did you give me exactly? Oh, knuckle duster. Alright, it's not a shiv, it's just, yeah. A little bit of hardware. Jesus, that would be so nasty to be hit by that. Alright, can you put your fist down, please? Alright. The thing is, I still have them on my hand. I can see them down there. Can I take them off? I feel like the guards would not like seeing me with the knuckle duster on. I don't think I can. Alright.
You know there's no way out of this slam.
Let's go speak with Rust. Such a good-looking game.
Okay, let's get him.
This is Aquila territory. You motherfucker!
Jesus.
He's here. Riddick is here.
I'm gonna fucking die, man.
Jesus. This guy's a lot harder than the last ones. There we go. Yeah, who's next? Come on.
We're gonna kill you!
Are you doing a pretty bad job of it, motherfucker? Give me that money. Use Quilo Med Health Trophy? What? Smoke with packaging intact. Huh? I don't even know what that means. Oh, I just got a different kind of knuckle duster. Huh. Better or worse than the last one I got? I suppose it doesn't matter, because I just replaced it, and I didn't drop the old one on the ground, so I guess I'm stuck with it. Oh, Rust, I'm coming for you!
Taste this, Riddick! I'm gonna kill you!
There's a shiv.
I'm gonna snap your head off and piss down your neck.
So they've got some traps waiting for me.
Riddick, you're gonna die.
Did you really think I would fall for that, huh? I'm not sure if I'm actually stabbing him. I mean, you can't really block a stab. So I can only imagine I'm actually stabbing him. There we go. Ooh, oh god. Ah. What if I do the, what if I time it just right? Wait till he attacks and then... I don't think it works. No, all right. I was thinking maybe I could do like the guard disarm thing where if you attack right when they attack, that you're fine. Let's get healed up. Can I not use this? Oh, there we go. Yeah. That's the animation I was talking about. It's lovely, isn't it? Nothing would make you want to visit one more than huge, gigantic needles stabbing you in the neck. I think I'd rather stay sick than do that.
Get ready to die, Riddick.
Hello, Rust. Alright, this is actually not going very well. Shit.
Get ready to die, Riddick.
Riddick.
Alright, let's try the knuckle dusters. There we go.
So this is a beast of Butcher Bay, huh? Head of the killing gang.
Looks like I need a new rooster. You interested? They respect you now, Riddick. I can make things easier. Say something. I take that as a no. Saying no to me is not the kind of mistake you want to make.
Are they coming for me, or are they just, like, patrolling the room?
He's oh, okay. Dead. I got a dead body here.
Well, that's a brilliant observation. Of course he's dead. He just got Riddicked. Vermin. It's a wonderful name.
That was really cool.
Thank you.
Way to cowboy up.
Not sure if I should grab the shiv. Because I'm pretty sure if the guards see you with the weapon out, they'll do something bad. I'm gonna grab it. Okay. It's fine. Whoa! Calm down. Not gonna hurt you, Moondog.
Stay the fuck away from me!
What the? Where did that come from? Enjoy jointly. Whoa!
Hey, prisoner! Show yourself! Motherfucker!
Jesus!
I got a dead body here.
No shit! You just shot him to death.
That was something, man.
What in the hell? What the fuck just happened while I was there? I guess this was probably here before, when I was coming down, but Jesus. Weapons such as shivs are not allowed in the prison area and will be killed on sight if you are seen carrying them. Knuckle dusters are too small to be detected. Okay, so stick with the knuckle dusters and I'm fine. Gotcha.
I heard you rejected Abbott. That's integrity. So, I'll keep my word. What do you want to know about?
The pit. Looks like a way out.
Way out? Sure. Raise some hell, and they throw you down. If you manage to stay alive, there's supposed to be a way into Pigsville from down there. But it's never been done.
I like a challenge.
Well, then, Pigsville's your place. Staff quarters, and you can get to the spaceport hangars from there. But you would need a rifle.
And they're all DNA encoded.
Yeah, and you'll fry if you touch them. And the DNA data bank is deep inside the mainframe area, past the infirmary.
So I just walk in, huh?
No, you gotta crawl. There is a passage from the infirmary that I think connects to the mainframe. Oh, and if you want to get through the infirmary gates, there's this hack. Name's Boulder. He owes me 150. Talk to him.
All right.
No more rust. And no illusions, eh, Riddick? Abbott will find another to take his place. Still, we owe you for a few days of quiet, if not peace. Here's a little something for your troubles, son.
A little bit of money. Thank you very much. That's the only thing he says. Some drunken rambling.
Hey, man. You want to buy a pack of smokes?
Yeah, let's buy some special smokes.
Hand them over.
Thanks.
Warning, excessive chewing may hurt throat. Huh? I really don't understand any of those warnings. Alright. Jesus. Okay, where's this guy? Infirmary. Yeah, I talked to Boulder to get into the infirmary. I don't know where the infirmary is or where Boulder is.
Coin, you know there's no way out of this slam.
Well, I'm assuming Boulder is one of the guards, right? Such as you? Yes.
Haley says you owe him.
He should get that money from you, Riddick. You screwed my bet on Rust when you downed him.
You screwed yourself by betting against me. Now, the infirmary.
Man, you look like how I feel, like shit. Okay, go on through. Hurry up.
Some fight, Riddick. Impressive. But Abbott's not gonna like it. Or you.
Oh my god. Why do I think this
just
place
wait
is
here
like
for the dock and don't you fucking dare move.
I bet this place is like 10 shivings
stay
a day.
Away or I'll blow your head
Jesus.
Off.
You just told me not to move. So which is it? Don't move or stay away from you. All right. So, do I need to take these guys down?
Fuck up.
Oh my god. They're beating the prisoners for screaming in pain. Yeah. I think I've got to take him down. I'm not sure if this guy has a gun, but this one does. I'm gonna wait till he moves and try to take him down from the back, and then this guy probably won't be too hard. Come on. Well, at least I made him do something. Fucking blood-covered operation table.
Code incorrect. Please enter correct code.
Alright, fuck it. Fuck it. getting my ass kicked here.
Die, motherfucker!
Jesus, alright. Knuckle Duster seemed more effective than a fucking shiv. Baby. Shit, I'm stuck.
I'm gonna crush your fucking skull.
Come on, come on. Oh, there we go. You can do a timed attack thing, even if you're just fist fighting. At least I think that's what that was. I don't suppose that got me any closer to getting the key, did it? No. I still don't have a code. They didn't drop anything, did they? Oh no, he did. There we go. Oh, I still don't have the code for that one. Alright. Nah, you didn't drop one. Okay, gotta get that from somewhere else. Oh, hi. Try to get the timing right. Come on. There we go. Yeah.
Now you're gonna die.
I'm still not quite getting it right. Come on. Well, that works good enough. Yeah, the timing's really hard to get right, actually. Very short window. Holy crap. What's this thing gonna do? Reconstruct my entire body? Oh my god!
Resilience strengthened. Only nanomech makes you stronger than you were.
Okay, so as part of the infirmary, there's something that permanently increases your health? A strange piece of future technology. Drag you into the dark here.
Looking.
Attention, riot in Block A. All personnel keep to standard riot procedure and await special task force.
Huh. Perfect time to do this then. They're gonna be a bit preoccupied. That's how they respond to riots, huh? They just shoot everybody? Alright.